Father's wake.
True.
He did ruin his deathbed.
Do you know how many years I was waiting to tell him?
Years. Literal years.
Could have said it before he had all the tumors.
That's not the point.
Don't start trying to make a fucking point now. They're dead now. They're all dead, so can't touch anymore.
I know they can't hurt me. It's the fact that they did.
We all ended the same way, didn't we? Whatever. Have it. That kills us. Smoking. Eating junk food. Whatever it was that drove our dearly departed father to drink himself to death. But I mean, the point is, we all have the same way of being remembered. Stone slab in a shallow pit. So, maybe next time, someone who birthed you, clothed you, fed you, gave you everything you could have ever wanted dies. Maybe try not to mention how everyone they knew was a terrible person. Hey, at least Mammy died, haven't you?
What happened to you?
Same thing that always happens. I'm heartbroken.
We have Bonnie.
Bonnie. Who lives in Virginia?
Virginia?
County cabin.
Well then what else could be wrong with you then? You have everything you could want. You have a roof over your head. You have a caring, some would even say loving sister.
Don't you dare use the word love around me.
Why?
Because I've been loved. Unconditionally and unquestionably. The only person who ever loved me or ever wanted me is now 6 feet underground.
We haven't even buried Dad yet.
I'm not talking about Dad, you fucking arsehole. I'm talking about Mom.
I was young when she was buried. I'm like 7. Stupidly, like any child would. I got in my head that, you know, Mommy died to have you.
But our mother died because of you.
I hated you. Now after you had your big moment with Dad, I thought it would be the best thing to do for the family, and I'm fucking stupid. A fucking stupid, horrible person.
But you'll never be Mom for me.
I didn't. It's okay. It's fine.
I don't blame you for what you said, though. I mean, I'm sure Dad would have done something about it.
Even if he did, I wouldn't change anything that happened to me. I don't know. I can't even say it.
Yeah, it's not good.
It's okay. No, it's all right, honestly.
Guys, so Devin's asking about the chandelier downstairs.
Fuck off.
Okay. It's a fucking way you duking up that.
Yeah, no, we don't want to.
If anything else, I wanted him to know what happened.
Are you okay?
Clearly preferred you.
You're joking.
I'm serious. Dad never had a moment of time for me. At least Dad had an interaction with you, no matter how brief it was.
I was there for half the time. He was either drunk or worse.
This is not a fucking joke to me. Can't think of a single second, like a single moment where our father said, I love you. Because I can't. Not one fucking time. I went my whole life and my father, our father, never said a simple three fucking words.
Neither did I.
Okay. I guess the only thing we have to surmise is that he didn't love either of us. It was just afterwards. He did always want to slum. It was around the same time I started liking girls, so I never told them, obviously. My father judging the way I loved would never happen. In a way, I respect that from you. I mean, like, stood up to him. Granted, he couldn't exactly talk back, but I'm proud of you.
Why can't we stop fucking talking about him? I mean, really, it's like an obsession or something. Just day after day. What, like, why are we the way that we are? Did we inherit this from Mum or something? Like,
I don't really think it matters anymore, though. In the grand scheme of things. I guess I was right. We all end up the same way. I'm not the chauffeur.
I mean, that's not entirely true. I have you and you have me.
Well, then I guess you're right. There's people still downstairs, so I think I'll head.
Yeah, I'll be down. I'll be down in a minute. It's okay. Probably for the best. I might set Dad's course on light.
I mean, considering how you drank, couldn't be too hard.
Oh.
Veronica?
Yeah.
I love you too.
Oh.
Kind of light that never shone on me. I want my life to be to live with you, live with you. There's a way, everybody say, to do each and every little thing. You don't know what it's like. Baby, you don't know what it's like to love somebody, to love somebody the way I love you.